this module, you should be able to at least know how to declare and initialize variables. You should also be know how to differentiate the difference between reference and primitive variables. And of course, we will try to manipulate those data using what we call the String Builder class and its methods. And number four, we will be creating and manipulating strings. Now, this is assuming that most of you were able to install NetBeans, and at least majority of you know how to create the very first Java program na pinagawa kong activity sa inyo last week. So, on my end, I will go ahead and open NetBeans. So, as you can see here, my NetBeans is now installed, and I'm going to at least show you, or from now on, we will be creating our Java programs directly here sa NetBeans. Yan. So let's talk about constants and variables. Now, when we say data in or a data item, okay, it is actually constant, because when we say constant, that is, or the value cannot be changed while a program is running. Say, for example, when you include the following statement in Java class, the number 449 is constant. Say, for example, you are trying to print out a number 459, that data alone is in constant. Okay? So every time an application containing the constant 459 is executed, the value 459 is displayed. So there are several number of ways where programmers refer to the number 459. Number one, it is literal constant because its value is taken literally at each use. When we say literally at each use, meaning we actually just simply put the number 459 directly to the system.out output print line. Number two, it is numeric constant as opposed to a character or a string constant. Number three, it is unnamed constant as opposed to unnamed one, because no identifier is associated with it. Now, we will be talking about what we call variable. Okay, since kapag sinabi kasi natin constant as is yung value, nandyan lang yan. It can be a literal constant, it can be a numeric constant, or an unnamed constant. Now, a variable is a named memory location that can store a value. Focus lang tayo dito. In layman's term, a variable is where you will now store the value of a specific data type na gusto mong paggamitan. I have here an example. Say, for example, if you create a variable named oven temperature. Oven temperature is an example of a variable. Okay? It might hold 0, and it might hold 0 when the application starts, and later on it can be altered to hold 350 and still be later be altered to hold 400. Unlike constants earlier, the variable now are dynamic, meaning it can be changed, it can actually be updated most of the time. So variables are nothing but reserved memory locations to store values. So this means that when you create a variable, you reserve some space in the memory based on the data, or based on the data type of a variable. Ano nga bang ibig sabihin ng data types? Now, for the data types, an item's data types describes the type of data. Ganun lang kasi simple. It's simply a type of data. In Java programming kasi, there are some two types of data types and eight primitive types of data na tinatawag natin. Number one, then, we have what we call byte. Pag sinabi natin byte, the description is actually here. You don't really need to bother yourself with the description, but I only included the description here just for the sake of everyone to have a knowledge or understanding how this data type byte works. So gawa tayo ng example natin dito. So in order for us to at least create an example, yan, gagawa ko ng bagong project dito. And I'll create Java class library. Sabihin natin demonst demonstration, yung project name. Now, in the demonstration, I'll right-click on that and click on Java class. And this time, I'll go ahead and provide a class name, data types. Ayan. Kapag ka isinom in natin yan, ganyan ang itsura. So kapag ka, ayan. So we have a public class data types. And sabi ko nung last week, your Java codes or your Java programs will only work if there is a main method. In order for us to do that, we can just simply type public static void main string args and like that. So let's talk about this first, okay? This first primitive data type na meron tayo. So let's try to print out. For example, yan. This is a byte data type. Anong ibig sabihin ng byte data type? It is an 8-bit signed to complements integer, and it has a minimum value of negative 128 and a maximum value of 127. Now, in order for you to at least know, or in order for you to at least declare a byte variable, you can just simply use here byte. Tapos sabihin natin dito byte A, for example. And now, the only values that we can store in byte A are from values negative 128 or hanggang 127. So, ganyan siya. So, kapag gagawa kayo ng variable, that's how you declare a variable. You have first your data type, followed by the variable. Ito, itong variable na to, it can be anything. Depende kung ano yung pangalan ng variable. So, in my case, I name that as A. And the value of the variable na gusto mong i-store sa letter A. So, in this case, if I will try to print out the value of A, I can just simply add a plus sign and add the value of A here. So, kapag ka ni-right-click ko yan, right-click, and run file, automatic, ayan, makikita natin dito, this is a byte data type, nagpakita dito yung negative 128 na value natin. Okay? So, testing natin, kasi ang maximum value is 127. So, kung 127 ang maximum value, tignan natin kung anong lalabas kapag 128. Now, you notice that once we type a value of 128 in or as a byte variable value, tignan nyo, nagkaroon tayo ng error. The error is incompatible types, possible lossy conversion from into type. Meaning, hindi kasi pwedeng maglagay ng 128. So therefore, you are not allowed to print this value of our variable A since byte only allows us to put a value hanggang 127. Okay? So, ganun din. Kapag short naman, tignan nyo lagi dito yung minimum value and maximum value. So, pag short, short P is equal to, and ano ang ano niya? 32,767. And, yan. So, again, I have declared a new variable B with a short data type together with its value. Now, let's try to print that. Short, this is a short data type. And this time, I'll print letter B. And look what will happen. Ayun. Diba? So, nagpakita na siya. Next, int. Ito yung int. Madalas natin gamitin ng int eh. So, the int value or the int minimum value is from negative 2 raised to 31 and 2 raised to 31 minus 1. So the maximum and minimum value is actually here. You don't need to memorize this one, pero at least you already know how to, or you already know the range na pwede nyong ilagay sa integer. Now, for example, and int c is equal to, ganyan, natin, 2,147,000, I mean 2,147,483,647. Ayan. So usually ginagamit ang int naman kapag gusto nyo mag-print ng mga numbers or mag-perform ng calculations so sa tingin nyo hindi naman ganun kalaki. Okay? Now let's try to print int c, which is 10. There you go. Ah? Next is what we called long. Ang long naman, from the word itself long, it's actually bigger than integer. It's bigger than integer. Yan, negative 2 raised to 63 and 2 raised to 63 minus 1. Now, the value for long can be like this. So long b equal to, tapin lang natin to kasi masyadong malaki. Yan. Hindi pwedeng maglagay ng comma sa numbers. Kasi nagkakaroon din ng error. Yan. Oops, meron tayong error. Integer number too large. Ayan, integer number too large daw. So, yeah, ano natin? Pwede nating ma-resolve yan by simply adding letter L behind the value of the number. Yan. L stands for long. So, kung napansin nyo, naglagay lang ako ng letter L sa pinaka-last part ng, ano natin, ng number, kaya na-resolve yung issue. Nung wala ito kanina, yan, merong error nagpapakita. So, nung naglagay ako ng L, there you go, it actually removed the error. So, this is a long data type. Kapag print mo na yan, yan, automatic, yung letter L dyan, nawawala yan. Okay? So, that's long. Next, we have what we call the float and double. Kapag float, meaning, we are actually trying, pag float and double kasi, pareho yung halos yan. But then, we are only trying to put a value with decimal places. However, float, okay, is actually used to save memory in large arrays, while double are usually being used and as the default data type for decimal values. Kapag ka gusto mo kasi na medyo mas makasave, pwede kang gumamit ng float. Yan. Example, float e is equal to 1.1, pero do not forget to add this time f. Double, and double f is equal to 1.1d. And yeah, that's how you declare float and double. Now, you will try to print them, float, double, e, f, and file, there you go. It produces the same 1.1 value kasi nga 1.1 lang yun dito. So, we have, again, tandaan nyo, kapag float, maglalagay ka ng F. Pag double, maglalagay ka ng D. Pero usually kasi, ako kasi personally, I am using float most of the time. Yan, kapag ka mga decimal values. Halimbawa, gusto kong pag-addin ang dalawang decimal values. I'm using float in my case. Yan. Next is what we call Boolean. Ang Boolean can only possess two values. It's either true or false. So, Boolean G is equal to true. Gathering false. Ganun lang siya. So, kung gusto mong, pag sinabi mo kasing Boolean, true or false lang yan. So, do not forget that part. Pinakamadali yan. Boolean is, there you go, true or false lang ang lalabas sa Boolean. The last data type that we have here is what we call char. Hindi char. Character yan. Okay? That's what we call character data type. Now, for the character data type, we can actually declare that by doing this. So R H is equal to this time, you have to enclose a character literal into a single quotation string para ma-print mo ito. Yan. So naka-ano siya, naka single quote string. So kapag i-print natin yan, this is a char data type, tapos i-print ko yung letter H na variable, automatic, it will give us that one. Nag-gets ba natin? Ayan o, example character, naka-enclose siya dito. Ayan. Maybe nagtataka kayo kung bakit kailangan yan. May explain yan later on kapag nagta-typecasting na tayo. Because, you know, I'll introduce to you what we call typecasting. Typecasting are simply the way on how we change the data type of a certain data type into the needed data type. Say, for example, ito. Kung gusto mong makita yung integer value ni character, ayan, all you have to do is to simply typecast that. Anong ibig kong sabihin ng typecast? Now, let's try to remove this. Ayan. Tinanggal ko yung single quotation sa letter A. Of course, magpo-produce yan ng error. Pero, kapag ka naglagay tayo dito, halimbawa, ito, ayan, and I added here an integer or yan na lang. Ayan. Tingnan nyo maigi ha. Ayan. Integer na naka open and close parenthesis tapos letter H. Yung H is letter A. This simply means that we are trying to get the value of the letter A into its corresponding integer value. So kapag kanirun ko yan, there you go. Saan nakuha yung 97? Diyan ngayon papasok yung tinatawag natin na ASCII codes. Okay? ASCII. So, pakita ko sa inyo, ha? Kasi search ko kasi sa Google, we have what we call ASCII table. Ayan. Ayan. So, for the ASCII table, each particular part of your keyboard does, okay, corresponds to a certain value ng integer natin. See, for example, yung letter A na small letter, ito. Yan. So we have a character A, small letter. Yan. Now, its value or its integer value is 97. For now, decimal kasi ang tawag nila dito. Pero it's integer. Sige, tignan natin kung letter A na capital. So baguhin ko dito yung char H. Gawin kong ganyan. And the char data type is 65. So, tama. Diba? Yung decimal value nito is 65. So, that's what we call the ASCII table. I hope at least you take a screenshot or pinicturean nyo itong ASCII table because that might come in handy later on in the future kasi gagamitin natin yan. Okay? So, this is what we call typecasting. We just simply place the typecasted value na gusto nating makuha out from the current data type na meron. Next, yan, we have the reference or object data types. Hindi pa naman natin totally gagamitin ito, pero these are the default value of any reference. Yan. And a reference variable can be used to refer any object of the declared type or any compatible type. So for example, ito. This will now or this can be learned in CP11B and animal object with an animal name. Animal is equal to this one. This is what we call the construction. And constructor pala, constructor. So for now, hindi pa natin ito papakilaman sa CP11B pa yan. Okay? So in Java, we have the following Java literals na gagamitin natin. It's a source code representation of a fixed value. They are represented directly in the code without any computation. Now, we have the following Java literal notation na gagamitin natin for you guys to understand that. So for example, burahin ko to lahat. I will now try to use this hello world. So magpiprint tayo ng hello world. Last week, I have introduced the meaning of LN. That means it's new line. Diba? And once na dinilit natin yung LN, automatic alam na natin yung mangyayari sa mga words na ipiprint natin. Now, same goes through with Java literals. In Java literals, we have the following. Backslash N simply works the same as new next line. Ayan. Kung ito, halimbawa ito, wala pa tayong nilalagay ni isang kahit anong backslash N or whatever, diba? As is pa yan. Pero once I added here a backslash N in between hello and world, ayan, there you go. Automatic, nagkaroon ng space or next line after the word hello and before the letter W. Pagka naglagay pa ako dito ng backslash N sa loob ng or sa gitna ng L and letter D, what do you think will be the output? There you go. Nahahati-hati siya. Diba? So that's the power of backslash N. Pwede niyong gamitin yan kapag napakadaming mga parts ng code ninyo ang gusto niyong lagyan ng next line tapos hindi niyo ma-afford na magkaroon ng print line kagaya ng ganyan na napakadami din. Diba? So, if you can still remember your activity last time, yung Java na pinaprint ko, this will also fix your problem na isang system.out.println lang. And ang gagamitin nyo instead of using multiple system.out.println. So, pwedeng-pwede nyo gamitin ito. And so on. Backslash R are simply carriage return. Ano ibig sabihin ng carriage return? Tingnan natin. Backslash R. Yun. Ang carriage return po, ayan, na-delete itong buong hello na to. Nag-proceed na siya dito sa world. Ayan nga. Halimbawa ito, itong backslash R. I am expecting na mag-print is, ito, tama. So, carriage return, meaning, buburahin niyo muna lahat ng characters in between the first letter up to the last letter na before doon sa backslash R na yan. Form feed, let's see what will happen pag nag-delay tayo ng form feed, backslash F. And pag form feed, and it produces, hindi kasi makita dito, kaya nagkaroon ng nag-result ng square. Backslash B or backspace. Ayan, hell world. Pansin nyo, backspace. Kasi meaning, pinura yung O. Backspace or backslash S. Oops, unfortunately, backslash S is not working anymore dito sa version natin. So I think hindi na siya pwede. Dati pwede to eh. Legal escape character. Ayan. Double backslash S. Ayan. Hindi pa rin pwede. So, wala ng backslash S. Backslash T or new tab. Ayan. Taon ng tab. Backslash double quote. Let's see what will happen. Ayan. Sabihin, naglagay ka lang ng double quote dyan. Backslash single quote. Ayan. So those are the Java literals na meron tayo. Backslash, backslash. Pagka gusto ko mong maglagay ng backslash. Ayan. Backslash triple D. Wala din. Hindi na rin pwede. And so on. Itong hexadecimal Unicode dito rin yung pwede. Okay, so those are the Java literals that we have. Let's proceed with the Java string classes. Medyo maiksi lang tong discussion for Module 2 kasi alam niyo yun, pinost ko na siya ng matagal and I'm expecting na kahit pa paano, sinusundan niyo na siya last week pa. So, for the Java string classes, yan, it's, take note ha, string is not a data type in Java. Remember that. Kaya nga kung napansin nyo kanina dun sa data types natin, I really did not include string as a data type. Though, it's correct that you can actually, you know, you can actually do declare a variable, like for example, greeting, and put a value in the greeting variable as hello world. Yes, totoo yan. However, it is not even still considered as a data type. Well, kung bakit magtatanong kayo why, well, it's because Java has been written like that. Hindi siya data type. So, I do not ever say the data type po ang string. Okay? So, whenever it encounters a string letter in your code, the compiler creates a string object when it is value or with its value, hello world. Ayan. So, kagaya rin ng pag-declare natin ng mga variable natin, possible din po na mag-declare tayo ng string. Kagaya niyan. Now, we can actually concatenate two different strings. When we say concatenate, meaning we are trying to combine two or more strings into one particular string. Say, for example, ito. I would like to print out the value greeting. And now, kapag ka mag-concatenate ako, I can just simply add a plus sign together with this one. Double quotation and the word na gusto nyo. Ayan. Concatenation. So, from the declared variable greeting na naglagay na ako ng value dito na hello world, and pwedeng-pwede na tayo ngayon magkaroon ng concatenation in which I am or I added another word here sa system.out.println natin. Pwede ka pang ulit mag-declare ng panibago dito na string name is equal to yan. Tapos, you can just simply put here a backslash n para mag next line. And another plus and add the name. Ba? So, it's really possible for you in Java programming to place or concatenate as many strings as you can. Ganun din, same din kapag ka numbers. Say for example, 8 plus 5. Ayan. But 8 plus 5, look what will happen. And it became 13. Diba? Became 13, which, well, obviously, ganyan talagang lalabas. Kahit na magkadikit pa yan, 13 pa rin yung lalabas. Diba? Pero if we enclose that in double quotation mark, tapos pa ganyan, hindi po magpa-perform yung calculation na to, but rather, Java will think that anything inside the double quotation mark will become or will be considered as a string literal. So, hindi yan 13, but instead, 8 plus 5 pa rin. Okay? So, we also have here formatting strings. Yan. The printf and format methods are used to print output with formatted numbers. Say, for example, yan, yung printf method na ginagamit natin. System.out.printf yan. Ang ibig sabihin ng printf and the value of the float variable is dito merong percent sign na f. Ayan. This simply means that you are trying to add a float variable and dito. So, float over is equal to 2.0f. Ayan. I declared a variable float var with 2.0f value. Now, I'm trying to use printf here para at least maipakita sa inyo na possible din pong gumamit tayo ng printf and the %f na parang C-sharp programming language din siya. Pagka-print natin yan, well, obviously, magpiprint yung 2.0 float variable natin. Kapag format, and halos it's the same, pero look what happened. Pag format method, yan, string that format. It's actually almost the same, pero you are simply formatting them. Ayan, ah. So, this time, meron tayong variable na fs, empty, that's null. It doesn't have any value. Pero on the next line, you added a value, which is string.format, together with the string literal, the value of the float variable, ito, itong nilagay natin, together with the %f and the float variable, float, nandito. Pero this time, instead of you printing out directly the value dito, you actually printed out the fs, which contains the string format. So it's almost the same lang dito, pero you know, hindi naman siya ganun ka-importante. Napakita ko lang sa inyo na possible siyang gawin. Next is yung mga string method natin. String methods are used to manipulate values such as converting all lowercase into an uppercase. So for example, ito, string text equal to small hello world. And let's try to convert this into an uppercase letter. So, ko-convert ko yan, I will now declare another variable text up equal to x dot to uppercase. Ayan. So kapag ka-printin ko na yan dito, system.out.println, tapos gamitin ko yung text up, and I'll try to run that. Boom. Yung hello world na dineclare natin as text na small caps, naging big caps na siya. So, that is actually the same when you are trying to print your name as ganyan. Diba? So, first, dineclare mo. Nag-declare ka ng variable text with its value. Now, you actually try to convert the text. Yan, text.toUppercase. Those are string methods. And meron pa tayong mga string methods kagaya ng char at. For characters, and ang char at kasi are simply you are trying to take a look at the position of the character. Character specifically. So, tingnan nga natin yan. For example, ito, text up. And text up that char at. Meaning, yan, pag zero, tignan natin kung ano yung magpiprint. Zero means you are trying to take a look at the character position from zero, starting to zero. In Java, ang pagbibilang po will always start from zero. So, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. So, kapag ka 1 yan, expect yun na letter E ang lalabas. Ayan. Diba? And yes, possible po na pag-convert tayo ng uppercase and at the same time, nagka-carat tayo. Possible po yan. Ano pa? We have here split text up. For example, dot split. Tignan natin kung anong mangyayari pag-split. And ano yung i-split natin? Oops, nagkaroon ng error. Error din. Oops, error ulit. And hindi siya pwede dito eh. But basically, what we're trying to do here is to simply split up. Okay? Teka, baguhin ko na lang muna yung value ng text natin. String greeting is equal to hello world. Ayan. Tapos greeting dot split. Ayan. The split here simply means the method works and splits the string around matches of the given regular expression. Yan, meron pala siyang paganyan. Registry expression. I mean, regular expression. Kaya siya nag-error kasi hindi pa natin ginagamit ang regular expression. So, saka na ang split. So, possible po yan. Kapag ka naglagay ka kasi dito ng mga regular expression like A minus or A maganyan. Kaso for na, wala pa eh. Kaya nagkakaroon tayo ng error na kaganyan. And next, dot length. Length simply means you are trying to take a look at the size of the entire, and that includes the spaces. So kapag ka naglagay ako dito ng the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog, it will check the length together with the space in between. And so there are 43 characters sa lahat ng yan. You can also and check and greeting that equals and for an ene for condition. Here for example, gusto mo mapalabas kung yung laman ba ni greeting is hello or false, true. Diba? So kung hello to yan, false na yan. That's dot equals. Same goes true with dot equals ignore case. You are just simply ignoring the case as well. Now, pakita ko sa inyo. Kung halimbawa ito eh parang Jejemon. Tapos, we are trying to equals ignore case. And hello. Will still produce true since we ignored the case in this case. Kasi nga kanina, it's case sensitive. So kung ano yung gusto mong, kung ano yung kino-compare mo, it should match exactly what you are trying to compare dun sa greeting variable. Pero this time, when I put equals ignore case, it doesn't matter. For as long as pareho yung value nito and here, it will always produce an output of true. Oh, yun, tapos na pala. Okay, so ito naman, nilagay ko dito kung paano gumawa ng your first Java program, which is okay lang. I know, alam nyo na to. Wala na kayong problem sa part na to. And, pero if I were you, susundan ko po ito para at least alam ko kung paano mag-change or maggawa ng project dito sa NetBeans. Saan ba yung ano? Ayun. Okay? So let's proceed here in your self-check. Now, for your self-check, you will answer the following activities. Pakita ko po kung ano yung mga kailangang sagutang activities for today. The self-check, that is actually the quiz number 2, I think. Yun. So for the quiz number 2, I will now be adding and a time limit, which is 30 minutes, and the due date up until next week during our class 11:10 a.m. Okay. Ano pa ba? Yeah. Performance task number 2. Ito. for performance task number two, that is laboratory activity number two yan. Ito yan. So all you have to do here is to open this website. Look for 7 different facts based from the website. Now, for each fact, you have to identify the suited Java data type. Okay? So, hahanap kayo doon ng mga short data types, byte data types, and initialize that value by declaring a Java data type. And you have all you have to do is to simply print. Yan. Print those using the data type na pinagamitan niya. So this is alone is ilang points to? 12 points. I have placed here the following questions. And edit natin, maglagay na tayo ng due date hanggang next week, this day.